हेलो, वेलकम टू एडुफंडा। आई एम योर मेंटर फॉर दिस टॉपिक केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम पार्ट सेकेंड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू नो अबाउट द डायनेमिक इक्विलिब्रियम। एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर अबाउट द इक्विलिब्रियम, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डायनेमिक इक्विलिब्रियम। When the reactant in a closed vessel at particular temperature react to give product, the concentration of reactant keep on decreasing with increase in time and remain constant after some time. That means, if we draw the graph between reactant and concentration with respect to time, then the reactant will go decrease simultaneously and after some time it will remain constant. For example, if I am taking some reaction PCl5 that is dissociated into PCl3 plus Cl2. If I am saying initial concentration is 1, so at t equals to 0 time, that means the reaction is didn't start yet, then their concentration is 0, their initial mole is 0. After some time, t equals to t time, after some time, when I have seen that 1 minus x, some part of this is dissociated and some part is made in PCl3 and Cl2. That means the reactant, यहाँ से हम देख पा रहे हैं कि reactant क्या हो रहा है, decrease हो रहा है और यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, product क्या हो रहा है, बढ़ रहा है. So this graph is also showing that कि after some time की reactant decrease हो जाएगा. But when I am seeing that t equals to t time, but when I am seeing that t equals to infinite time, so जब ये रिएक्शन पूरी की पूरी खत्म होने की बात यहाँ पर पहुंच चुकी होगी, तो ये क्या है, इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन है, वापस से बैकवर्ड शुरू हो चुका होगा, तो ये कम होना शुरू हो गया होगा और ये बढ़ना शुरू हो गया होगा, तो एक कंडीशन ऐसी आएगी जब इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन आ चुकी होगी, तो दैट्स व्हाई इट्स इन अ कॉन्स्टेंट टाइम. व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रोडक्ट्स कंसेंट्रेशन कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग विद टाइम एंड रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट आफ्टर सम टाइम. When I am drawing the graph of product with respect to time, see, the graph is going on like this. See, just, for example, just we have taken the previous example PCl5 से PCl3 plus Cl2. So, जब मैंने t equals to 0 time पर बताया तो ये 1 था, ये 0 था, ये 0 था. t equals to t time पर ये कितना होगा, 1 minus x, x और x. तो पहले 0 था, अब x हो गया, तो पहले से क्या हो चुका है, ये बढ़ चुका है, तो ये क्या हो रहा है, product क्या हो रहा है, increasing. और after some time, it remain constant. So this is the equilibrium. Now I am showing the graph between concentration with respect to time with whole reaction. For example, we have taken the reaction PCl5, PCl3 plus Cl2. Now we can easily say if initial concentration is 1, then the PCl3 and Cl2 equal concentration is 0, 0, and after t equals to t time, the initial concentration is 1 minus x. So here the x and x is will be there. So it means the whole graph will be shown like this way. And this condition is called the equilibrium condition. This shows the equilibrium condition. This is a reactant concentration and this is a product concentration. After some time, at a particular temperature, there is no change in the concentration of the reactant and product. This stage is of the reversal system is known as the dynamic equilibrium. Attainment of dynamic equilibrium. Now, based on the extent to which the reaction proceed to reach the state of chemical equilibrium, it can be classified into groups. How much? It's 3. Observe the graph. This is the concentration and this is the time. Now say, this condition is equilibrium. Think about it. This is the reactant concentration and this is the product concentration. And this condition, where all the things are same, and this condition is called equilibrium state. Now we are talking about observation from the graph. reactant concentration is very high at equilibrium and product concentration is very slow at equilibrium. The reaction in which all small amount of product are formed and most of the reactant remain unchanged at equilibrium stage. Observation from the graph. Concentration with respect to time, reactant concentration, this is, and this is the product concentration, is very high at equilibrium. And this condition, when both are constant, and this condition is called equilibrium condition or equilibrium state. The reaction that proceeds nearly to completion of the reactant or with negligible concentration of the reactant are left at equilibrium stage. Now, the third graph I have showing concentration with respect to time. Now, we can easily say the equilibrium state will attain here because the both are reactant product are here at equilibrium condition. This is a reactant concentration, that is a product concentration, and this condition is called a equilibrium state. This graph reflects that at equilibrium stage there is a measurable constant concentration of both product and reactant. Thank you for watching Edufunda. Visit our website www.edufundaventures.com.